We're off to the forest to see Miss Jean. She lives in a house that is mostly green, except for the chimney and windows and walls, and one or two places just down the halls. And it's filled with rabbits and newts and snails, and fat little puppies that wag their tails, and a whale and a tiger and elephants too.
Well, maybe not elephants.
Hi, kids. Did you see what I was doing over there?
Looking at the wren's house.
Right. It sounds like they're about ready to escape, doesn't it? You keep an eye on the wren's house, too, or an ear out for them, because they're getting so big now, their parents are coming very often to feed them, and we might be lucky enough to see them if we don't make too much noise. We have another baby bird to take a look at this afternoon, and some things that sting. You be thinking about all the things you know that sting, or that you've heard might sting. There's some things that don't sting, but there's a lot of superstition about them, and people think they do sting, so we're going to talk about those too. But let's take a look at this funny little bird named Jay first, but he's not a jay. Come here, Jay.
Is it a baby starling?
You're right, Alan. How do you know so much about baby starlings?
Because we have two nests of baby starlings around our house.
Oh, well, that's a good way to get to know them if you have a chance to watch them. And he's at a very nice stage.
He's hungry.
He's not quite big enough to take off on his own, and he knows that if he sticks around people. Hear the wrens? I think one of the parents just went in with some food. If we keep an eye there, we'll see it come out.
It's hungry.
Feeding baby birds is a problem, whether you're a mother bird or a father bird or a person that has to take care of a baby bird.
Come on.
Well, let's take care of Jay. He eats all kinds of things. He belongs to a new friend of mine named Sam Strang, who's lives in Memphis, Tennessee. That's a long ways away. Oh my goodness, what a hungry. He makes more noise than the whole house full of wrens, doesn't he?
He dropped it. Maybe he can throw it in.
Boy, doesn't he have a big mouth? You know what this is that Sam's grandmother fixed up for him to eat? Well, probably got some hamburger in it.
Here.
One of the very best things that you can use to feed baby birds, if you have to, is dog food.
Dog food?
Yeah. Dog food that comes in a can, you know. It's all mixed up and it's soft.
Is that what it is?
Yeah. And Aurora thinks that he oughtn't to be left out. As long as people are eating, he wants to eat too. So there's a piece of bread for Aurora. How can you tell he's a baby, Alan?
Because he's got little downy feathers.
Right, he has little tufts of downy feathers. You know, sometimes I say some things about say that starlings are pests.
They aren't. Some help you, like get.
But they do some good things, like eating Japanese beetles. There are not very many birds that eat Japanese beetles. It's just when there are too many in one place, they get to be a pest. But one of anything can be a very interesting pet for a while. Uh-oh, don't you eat my specimens, Jay. Let's see what else he has to eat there. Here's something.
Wings.
Here's something I bet you like to eat, Alan and Elizabeth. Recognize this? What do you think the starling thinks it is?
Worms.
he thinks it's worms, and starlings like worms. What birds are famous for liking
robins?
Robins. I knew a lady once that
he saw wood.
a lady saw some robins out in the spring when the cold weather was cold, and she put out spaghetti for them, but she dyed it pink so it would look more like worms. Wasn't that really being a bird lover?
Yeah.
Any more? Uh-oh. My aim isn't as good as a mother starling. Does this starling look like a grown-up starling?
No. No. He ain't black.
He's not black yet. For the first summer, that he's going to stay grayish brown. Some people don't even recognize starlings when they're that color.
He's got big feet.
What are you having, Aurora? You going to have some spaghetti too? Aurora doesn't like spaghetti. Well, that was a very, very nice.
Don't you jump off?
Patient bird. Where does starlings live, Alan? Have their nests?
And you see the nest I saw, it was in a hole of a rotten branch.
Right. They live in any kind of a hole. A hole in your roof or a hole in a branch. Even a birdhouse, as long as there's a hole to go in.
Because we had a nest in our chimney. We thought it was a chimney swift.
But it was a starling? Yeah. What did you got?
In our, when we went up to our roof, we were cleaning out the gutters. We found the, we found a nest, and that a bumblebee came out of it. There's a hole in the roof.
Oh, well, I'm glad you mentioned bumblebees, because I have some bumblebees for us to look at today. Watch out, Jay. He's not quite sure of his footing yet, is he? Another way you can tell he's a baby is by his bright yellow around his mouth. Very young. We'll try him on one more piece of spaghetti before we put him back in his box. I don't think he's too hungry anymore. He has to eat about every half an hour, but he doesn't eat an awful lot.
That's what it said
time.
In the books. All birds have to be fed in a half an hour, every half an hour.
Okay, Jay. Oh, he has to scratch his head before he goes back. Those little tufts of down look like little horns or ears, don't they? Do birds have ears?
Yes, they're all the way underneath their feathers.
Right, hidden under his feathers, right behind his eyes. Okay.
I know where a chickadee's nest was, and I saw the little babies.
Oh, they're cute. They're so tiny.
These were big. Wait.
Sam's going to take care of him until he's big enough to let go.
Where'd he find him?
He found him at a friend. He has a friend named Donald Smith, who has a lot of different kinds of birds, and the starlings were living in his garage, and one of them fell out.
In our barn, we had barn swallows nest, and one of them was new.
They're fun to watch. Well, let's talk about things that sting. And Elizabeth already mentioned one thing that stings. What was that you mentioned, Elizabeth?
A bumblebee.
A bumblebee. Well, I have an experiment here. I think there's a bumblebee in this box. In his nest. And what do you think is going to happen if I dump the nest out on our stump here?
He's going to come out.
He probably will come out. This is a very interesting story. I was helping my mother the other day clean out her dressing room at her swimming pool, and she said there's a funny noise coming from this pile of leaves on the bench.
Uh-oh.
And so I went over and I listened, and sure enough, there was a funny noise. What kind of a noise do you suppose it was?
Bees.
Just a buzzing noise every time you touch the leaves. So that I decided there must be a bee of some kind in there. So I just scraped the whole nest off into this carton, and I just saw the bumblebee up here on top. So there's one bumblebee, and we don't know whether he has a nest in the middle. Oh, there went the rat again. You can tell every time you hear the noise. Let's watch and see how long it is before she comes out. I don't know whether it's the mother wren or the father wren, because they both look alike.
They do?
Yeah. What kind of wrens are those?
House wrens?
House wrens, right. They live in a house.
Because those look like a house. It's a bird house.
And they also like to live close. There went. off to get more food. Okay. Now, do you think a bumblebee could build a nest like this all by itself?
No.
One bumblebee?
No.
Well, what do you think happened?
Maybe some of
There was a pile of leaves, and he just made a nest inside.
All right, who do you think would make a pile of leaves in a building that wasn't used for a while?
Yes, well, there he is.
Oh, do you see him?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Aren't you a little kid?
Oh, no.
Fingers? them.
Yuck.
So, well, if there's only one bee...
Maybe there's more inside.
All right, now what you're thinking... Now, bird, this was on a low bench, just about this high. Did you ever see a bird that built a nest down low? So think again.
Brown.
What?
Squirrel?
What kind of animal would come into an old building where nobody was and build a nest in the
rat,
wind?
Rat, mice.
Good. This looks like an old mass nest. And I think this might be a queen bee that's looking for a place to start her spring colony.
Because they like drill holes in wood.
Right. Well, that's the carpenter bee, right? One day there was one that was drilling a hole in the bottom of the wren house before the wrens moved in. That was exciting. But here she is. She doesn't look very dangerous, do you think?
No, no. But they were queen bees who were just like that.
Yeah. Well, it's all kinds of bees have queen bees. Honey bees have queens and all kinds. I think this is a queen bumblebee. Let's tear the nest apart and see if we can find any signs
eggs.
Of eggs. Right. Right.
What are you doing?
I better not get too close, Alan. Some bees sting and some bees don't. Do you know whether it's the father or the mother bees that can sting?
Fathers.
What do you think Elizabeth?
Like queen has a castle and there's many people in it, and there's two like guards at the door, and they don't sting you unless you do something to them. But they may think, but still they may do it. They may think you're trying to attack them.
Right, they sting to protect themselves, don't they? Defend their castle, so to speak, or their hive. Well, it's only the female bees that can sting because the stinger is just a modified egg layer, you know, and only the mother bees have ovipositors to lay eggs with. And that's what they sting with.
Once we saw a bumblebee and he was almost dead.
Dust. All kinds of things coming by.
And he was lying there and his stinger went in and out. So we pulled the stinger out and it's really sick. It's like a green, like pus.
That sounds like a rather gruesome thing to do, Elizabeth.
I know. I just wanted to see what
I think you're going to be a scientist when you grow up because you're curious about things. Well, so far it just looks like a old mouse nest, doesn't it? Do you see anything that looks like wax or honey? Or so maybe the bee was just beginning. Maybe she was just in there exploring around and thinking about starting a nest.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's one place to look for a bumblebee's nest, in a pile of leaves, in a quiet place. And we were lucky and we didn't get stung.
I wonder where the queen bee is now.
There's an old saying that says if a queen bee stings you, it got to be in the hospital by a certain time.
Oh. I haven't heard that one, Alan. You know some very interesting things. What about this?
Dragonfly?
Yeah, dragonfly. What do you know about him? Some people say
sting.
They're dangerous and they sting. Do you think that's true?
That's a little bit, but they're not really dangerous.
What kinds of things do you know? One big family of insects that practically all the stinging insects are in. We just looked at one. The bees.
Dragonfly?
Not the dragonfly, no. Bees,
wasps,
hornets, and ants.
Bees.
That's the family that has things in it that can sting. And this is a dragonfly. It's in a different order of insects, and it doesn't sting.
There's some that are real little.
It doesn't.
Yeah, they're blue.
No. Some are blue, some are green, some are red, some are yellow, some are black and white. Dragonflies are beautiful, and they come in lots of colors.
They don't sting?
No, they don't sting. Some people think they sew up your mouth. If you tell a lie, doesn't that sound? But some people still say stories like that. Is the dragonfly a good insect to have around or not?
Good.
Good. Right. Yeah. What do you suppose it eats?
Insects.
Right, like mosquitoes.
Yeah.
So be kind to dragonflies. They do
a
good job.
I have enough mosquitoes. No,
mosquitoes bite. They don't sting.
Some people really sting.
Now I'm trying a little trick in my thermos jug to keep some of my bees
froze
quiet so we can get a good look at them.
He's froze. Yeah.
It's pretty tricky to try to get them cold enough so they hibernate for a little while and not too cold so they die. So let's see how this one looks.
Is that a wasp?
Yeah, this is the this is a hornet, a yellow hornet. The European European hornet.
I wouldn't do that.
Let's see if she's going to wake up. Insects are cold-blooded, so when you put them in a cold place, it's like winter coming. And
How can you tell if it's a girl? What is it they do? They usually have a sting.
There comes the bee back. The females usually have bigger abdomens. The back part, because they're full of eggs. And sometimes you can see the egg layer sticking out. Now, I don't want her to come back to life while I'm holding her in my hand, do I?
When we visited you, before you had a thing, some kind of a green bug, and had its egg, its abdomen.
One of the best places to look for this kind of hornet is under fruit trees at the end of summer, you know, when there's some pears lying around or apples that nobody ate. That's where the hornets come. And why do you suppose they come?
So they can, you know, ants come to eat some of the apple.
Right, to get the juice out of the apples. They don't care if it's a little bit rotten.
They do holes sometimes. Right. Maybe.
Yeah, well, let's look at him or her. Let's put this one down and you watch and see if she starts to wiggle her toes.
I wouldn't like to be holding any.
Her antennas are moving.
He's awake.
He's awake. Waking up slowly. Is that how you feel in the morning when it's time to get up and go to school? You like to wake up slowly?
Yeah.
Well, what is this?
Queen bee.
That's a bumblebee, and I don't know whether it's a queen bee.
That's the kind we have in our roof.
Maybe the people over in your neck of the woods call them queen bees. I always call them bumblebees. They have lots of. How can you tell a bumblebee, say, from a honeybee that makes honey?
Because they got like fuzz on them.
Right, they're much bigger. Here's a honeybee.
They're much bigger too.
And bumblebees are much bigger, and blacker, and black and yellow stripes. And the honeybee is small.
Down at my house.
He's awake.
Yes.
Down at my house, we had this real tall tree, and the lightning struck a branch, and there was honeycombs on from the honeybees.
Oh, did you get some honey?
They didn't make it yet. They just made the comb.
Oh, because it was just beginning. Well, that would be nice to have some real wild honeycomb. Mm-hmm. Would you bring me some next time you come? Save it for me.
Maybe my
friend.
Oh,
now.
Excuse me, Elizabeth. She's getting alive.
Oh, yes. Now I don't think I'll pick her up because I know that she can sting. Because now that she's coming back to, now she's waking up. Maybe she won't sting, though, as long as she's cool. How can you tell insects that belong in this group? They're called hymenoptera. That means they have wings you can see through, very thin wings. Have you noticed that about bees and wasps, that their wings are transparent? Very thin, and you can see through them. Bees, ants, wasps. Bees, ants, and wasps, what did I leave out? Bees, ants, wasps, hornets, and bumblebees are the main things in this family.
I dare you to pick up that wasp.
Take a look at these thorns on my necklace.
Around you.
Oh, I'm not worried about it.
You went back in the thing.
Did I ever tell you about these horns? These horns on my necklace? These thorns that are shaped like horns? And they come from down on some Caribbean islands. And the tree is called the bullhorn acacia.
You had a red one.
Yes, I have lots of them. I'm very fond of them. But the interesting thing about them is that ants live in these thorns on the acacia tree. And they can sting. The ants drill little holes and go in there and live, set up housekeeping. And have you ever been stung by an ant?
No.
Yes.
You have? So you know that they can be stinging insects too. Not all ants and not all bees, but quite a few of them. So here's the bumblebee. Let's put the bumblebee down. Whoops.
Get him off.
Oh, there goes the European hornet. Didn't take her very long to revive. Here, let's put you down. Why do you suppose they're called bumblebees?
Because maybe they extra sting.
Maybe because of the noise they make. I don't know about that.
The other one went down in the piles of leaves.
Let's take a look at some flowers that bees and hornets and wasps like to visit. Here's a funny one. Maybe you ought to have some of this at your house, Alan. Don't you have trouble with moles?
Yeah.
This isn't a very beautiful flower, but it's interesting because...
There's another bug.
The theory is if you plant this in your yard, it chases the moles away. I'll have to give you a plant. Maybe you can take this one home and plant it because you have a problem with moles. And what comes out when you pull off a leaf?
Milk-like?
Milky juice, right, but it's not a milkweed. It belongs...
Could you eat it?
No, don't. It's probably poisonous. But that's one way to tell this plant. It has these funny little flowers on, and I found a honeybee getting nectar out, pollen out of these flowers this morning. So it's good for bees, and it's supposed to be good to chase away moles. But it's not very beautiful, but it's called the mole plant. That's easy to remember.
I guess I'm counting.
Does it have a Latin name?
Oh, yes, it has a Latin name. Euphorbia something or other. But
yikes.
Here's now the bumblebee was making a noise. Here's one of my... goodness, I'm losing my voice. Here's one of my favorite flowers. Oh, there's where our queen bee went. She decided to visit the laurel. Maybe she's hungry because I've had her shut up in that box overnight. I wanted you to see this flower. Do you know the name of it?
It looks like a decoration on a cake.
It looked like frosting on a birthday cake to me. It's called the mountain laurel. And it's another plant that's poisonous to eat, but very beautiful to look at.
Here comes the other bee trying to get on it.
All the bees like the mountain laurel. This is a wild shrub and very beautiful. And the thing that happens when a bee...
Look, he's getting his nectar.
Yeah, you watch him, but listen. When a bee lands in one of these flowers, all the little stamens jump out of their pockets and throw pollen all over the bee's tummy. So then when the bee goes to the next flower,
he drops it on that.
He takes the pollen from one flower to another, and you know what that's called? It's a big word. Cross-pollination, taking the flower from one to another, and that's one of the good jobs that bumblebees and honeybees and a lot of our stinging insects do. They cross-pollinate. Now, that bee is washing its face.
Yeah, but this one
he got pollen on his face. What's the name of this beautiful flower?
There's another one, three
of them. Mountain laurel. And a flower that has stamens like that that pop out when
I've seen there's three of them.
There's one there, there's the one there, there's one.
Oh, we're very popular. How did they know we were going to talk about stinging insects this afternoon?
I guess that attracted them.
Listen to this. Several flowers are like this, and when a flower has stamens that pop out when an insect lands on them, those are called irritable stamens. Do you know what irritable means? Does your mother ever get irritable?
Yeah.
You know what that means?
Frustrated
and jumpy, you know, liable to snap your head off for the least little thing. Well, that's the way these stamens act. They just jump right out of the petals and on and throw their pollen all over the bee. Well, that's very obliging of that bee to go and show us how he works on flowers, or she.
Maybe one's a he and the other's a she.
Two bees on two branches of mountain laurel. Sam's grandmother let me have this from her bush this morning. It was so pretty.
People say that they're called cigar trees because they grow like cigars.
People say they're called cigar trees. Right. When do the cigars come, Alan?
After the flowers.
After the flowers, because they're the seeds. Let's park the bees over here for a minute. Don't want to bother them in their job. This is one of my favorite flowers. When I was a little girl, I lived in Mississippi for a while when I was about your age. And I used to go across the street and admire the catalpa flowers when they were blooming because they're so pretty. Would you like to look right down into one? And if you want to go out and look and see how many kinds of bees and wasps and ants and hornets you can find without bothering them or having them bother you, just go to a tree or a bush that has beautiful flowers on it, and you'll be surprised how many kinds of stinging insects you can see that are just going about their business of collecting nectar and pollen and not hurting anybody.
They have the skin of where they came out.
Those are called the sepals at the bottom here. The sepals and the petals.
Out.
And if you keep an eye, if you know where there's a tree like this, the catalpa tree, keep an eye on it. After the flowers fall, they'll get long pods on them like cigars.
And they're first a green and then they turn brown.
Or some people call them bean trees. The catalpa. See, I had one more interesting bee that does a funny thing. It makes a tunnel out of mud.
A mud bee?
Well,
mud wasp.
It's called a flower bee because it visits flowers.
That's like a little queen
bee. And a friend of mine told me that it didn't sting, but I don't know whether I'm going to pick it up or not. Oh, sounds sort of mad.
Does it sting you?
A flower bee, and so far he's not stinging. But they live in mud walls, and they go in and bring out little balls of mud and make a little mud tunnel.
We have lots of them up in our barn.
You
really?
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's falling down into the bumblebee's nest.
Them and mud wasps.
Yeah. Oh, well, this is different. Mud dauber is another kind of wasp. But this is a bee that makes a mud tunnel. Come here, flower bee.
Look at this bee. He's right in there.
This one must be a young one that doesn't know much about flying yet. Don't make him mad, Alan. Or her.
Mm-hmm.
There's also a plant that stings. Did you ever get
Kansas
stung
sting.
By yeah, a stinging nettle? And then there's something that the ocean when you
You're
go swimming.
Sea.
Yeah, well, that's a sea nettle, right? So that's a very, very interesting to think about, the things that sting. But really, they only sting when they're trying to defend their
home. He's different from them because he doesn't have yellow jacket.
That's right, and he's very small, isn't he? And he lives in a hole in a mud wall.
Looks like he's kicking.
Speaking of stinging, there's an ant stinging me on the ankle right now.
Uh-huh.
I chased him away.
A carpenter ant.
This bee is giving me a very nice cooling off. See, he's fanning.
That wind's
well, I hope you enjoyed meeting the baby starling named Jay and thinking about some different kinds of stinging insects like bumblebees, the European hornet,
the honeybee,
dragonfly that doesn't sting.
He
right.
Doesn't sting.
And the flower bee that lives in mud tunnels that drills out of the wall. Right. And the hornets. That make the great big paper nests, and the mud daubers that live in Alan's barn, and bumblebees that build nests in Ole's mouse nests.
Okay.
Goodbye, and come back very soon again to see us at Hodgepodge Lodge.
Through funds contributed by members of the Maryland Center for Public Broadcasting.
In the studios of the Maryland Center for Public Broadcasting.